give credit to the
institution as I was.
And remember my life partner.
Rabies is a genus, Lyssa virus, vesicular virus, and the family is Rhabdoviridae. This is a rabies virus which has got a bullet shaped appearance, and then it is commonly present in most of the animals, both in civic and wildlife. Single stranded ribonucleic acid helical coil nucleoprotein. Earlier, the structure of the rabies virus was not very important, but today, with the development of mononucleic antibodies, it has become very important and the structure is being reanalyzed again. The life of the virus, it lives less than a minute at 56 degrees centigrade temperature, and the lipid coat of the virus is disrupted by 1% soap solution. Therefore, the virus outside the nervous system does not have much viability. Once the virus enters the tissue from the saliva of the biting animal, replicates in the muscles near the bite. The virus moves up the peripheral nervous system to central nervous system, ascends to the spinal cord, reaches the brain and causes fatal encephalitis. From the brain, it enters the salivary gland and other organs of the victim. This is a life cycle, and the aim of treatment is to prevent the virus from reaching the central nervous system. That's what we are attempting. Once we suspect the virus has been inoculated into the human being, our aim is to prevent, have this diagram in mind, and prevent the virus reaching the central nervous system. Aim of treatment, to prevent the virus from invading the central nervous system. First thing is wound toilet. It is very essential, washing and flushing with soap and water, or water alone for 15 minutes. After going through few literature, that is, people dealing with this, wound toilet has been emphasized by many people in the present context, and also they have also emphasized that it should be of longer duration for 15 minutes. The various agents commonly available with us are two, which are available with everywhere: Providone iodine 1% solution, and if you are using alcohol, it should be 70% alcohol. These two are various agents apart from the soap solution which I have already mentioned. Therefore, these are the three agents that we use to clean the wound: soap solution, providone iodine, and 70% alcohol, and irrigate it for 15 minutes. Put the wound soaked with these solutions and allow it to stay for 15 minutes before we clean and dress. Now, we have got the vaccines. Vaccines have been there with us for a long time. The only recent change that has happened with the community approach is that intramuscular regimen and intradermal regimen. The difference in community practice: intramuscular regimen needs 1 milliliter or 0.5 ml vaccine, whereas intradermal regimen needs 0.1 milliliter. That means in a community practice and nationwide, the economy of it has been very nicely demonstrated, and hence most of the public health institutions are turning on to intradermal regimen. To follow intradermal regimen, you must have some expertise to give the intradermal injection, because most of the time it may go subcutaneous and the effectiveness of the vaccine may not be there. Therefore, it's very important the nurse or the doctor who is giving should look to it the blood is raised. If the blood is not raised, it is worthwhile repeating the intradermal regimen with another 0.1 milliliter of vaccine. The vaccines available with us are tissue culture vaccine, human diploid cell, purified chick embryo, and purified B roller vaccines. The amount of volume used for B roller cell vaccine is slightly less, 0.5 ml, but other two are 1 ml. And they have been with us for quite some time. Now we are no more using the neurodevelopmental vaccines because they were giving neurological symptoms apart from the disease itself. Other vaccines are purified duct embryo vaccine. It also has 1 ml of intramuscular use. Now, intradermal regimen, only two vaccines are used: purified chick embryo cell vaccine and purified B roller cell vaccine. Other two vaccines have not been so far demonstrated for the intradermal use. We have got four vaccines: human diploid cell, purified chick embryo, purified B roller cell, and other one, purified duct embryo vaccine. And the recommended vaccine for the intradermal regimen or purified chikungunya vaccine and purified meal or self-vaccine. Intramuscular regimen, it should be one injection. The number of injections are 5. The number of days are 0, 3, 7, 14, 28. 1 or 0.5 ml depending on the vaccine used on one deltoid only. That's very important to use the deltoid muscle. There have been some mistakes when you hand it over to the substar, they give it in the gluteal region. The defect in the gluteal region is that one, the amount of fat that is present in the gluteal region is more than the amount of fat that is present in the deltoid region, and hence the absorption of the vaccine is less from the gluteal region. Second, what actually we are aiming at is to put the vaccine ahead of the virus. We have demonstrated already in the earlier slide that the virus takes 14 days to go in, and we must reach the central nervous system earlier than 14 days. If that is not reached, the vaccination purpose is defeated. Therefore, the site is used is in deltoid. When we come to the intradermal regimen, the number of injections are 2. We should give on both the deltoids. Number of injections are 2, and we skip the 14th day dosage. This has been the recommendation by the authorities concerned, both nationally and internationally. When you use the intradermal regimen, 2 injections on both the deltoids, 0.1 ml only on days 0, 3, 7, 28. I repeat again for remembering purposes, intramuscular regimen, 5 injections, 0, 3, 7, 14, 28, 1 or 0.5 ml in one deltoid only. When you come to the intradermal regimen, 2202 number of injections in both the deltoids, amount used is only 0.1 ml with a definite insertion to see that the blood is raised. If the blood is not raised, please repeat the injection so that the effectiveness of the vaccine will not be compromised. Now, vaccines are the same. Some people, when I was preparing the site, some of the sub-staff and nurses asked me, does that prepare a different vaccine? No, vaccines are the same. Only the route is different. The route has also been made different purely for the sociological and national community purposes so that the cost of treatment will be brought down. And effectiveness, there has been slight controversy. Some people think effectiveness of intradermal vaccine is more, and that's why they are strongly advocated, but some authorities do not agree with that. That's the difference of opinion on that. But still, many of the institutions now started using the intradermal regimen. Now, pre-exposure prophylaxis, we can also use both intramuscular and intradermal regimens. The number of days are 0, 7, 28. This is essential for the people who have been exposed to the disease or the nurses who are treating. Now, institutions that take to treat the rabies case are less. Somehow they shun and avoid the rabies cases. But some of the institutions do take them on a that is, they get them separate and then they treat. Those nursing staff and doctors should be protected. Now, next, the first treatment is wound toilet, second treatment, vaccine. The third treatment that has been developed has also been with us for quite some time, is a human rabies immunoglobulin. Now, immunoglobulins are actual preparation of the globulins, and then prepared either from the animal source or the human source, and then they are used to prevent the virus at the wound level itself, before it enters the central nervous system. The purpose of the vaccine goes through the nervous system as per the rabies level, and then fights in the nervous system various points, and then neutralizes tissue. Whereas this is attack on the wound itself. Now, we have got the immunoglobulin from the human type, we have got the immunoglobulin from the equine, and the human is slightly less dose, 10 international units per kilogram, whereas the equine is more dose, 20 international units per kilogram. Now, what is the method? They test the intradermal hypersensitivity first. Very most important, vaccine, now we don't test the hypersensitivity, whereas immunoglobulins, you must test the intradermal hypersensitivity. Local infiltration around the wound, some distal into the intramuscular injection. To give an example, suppose the bite is in the leg, lateral aspect of the leg, you infiltrate around the lateral aspect of the leg, and also see which route the nerve goes on, whereas you have got the fifth nerve, the peroneal, the L5, you in the gluteal region, so the L5 segment is also protected. Therefore, there should be 2 infiltrations, one along the local wound, second along the nerve route through which the virus will travel. Now, this is the latest development, monoclonal antibodies against rabies. The study should go to the Mindshift Institute of Technology and also Serum Institute of India. Serum Institute of India along with the Mass Institute of Technology are the forerunners in developing the monoclonal antibody treatment. Now, the wound toilet is removing the aspect of virus as possible and the wound. The vaccine is competing with the virus rabies, going on along the nervous system, along with the root of the virus, and then trying to neutralize it. Immunoglobulin is again a part to neutralize the virus at the wound level so that the load of the virus will come down and the disease will be prevented. Now, monoclonal antibodies is the molecular based development, and the G protein, rabies G protein, is being developed against the rabies G protein. The technology used, the recombinant DNA technology, is incidentally better because, like insulin, human insulin, which is again recombinant technology, the animal protein is eliminated and human protein is also eliminated. Both in the human immunoglobulin and equine immunoglobulin, you have got the proteinaceous materials of the living organism, either in the human being or in the horse. Well, that is avoided in this because it is developed from the Chinese hamster ovary cells and available in 100 international units, 2.5 ml, and also higher strength is available. Now, each 2.5 ml of monoclonal antibody contains purified rabies human monoclonal antibody 100 international units, citrate buffer, citric acid and sodium citrate, and sodium chloride, polysorbate. These two are, because we are dealing with the in a treatment of rabies, the most important, apart from the disease, is the toxicity to the method of treatment we are using. Local wound treatment perhaps no toxicity, except some abrasions that you can always treat with tetanus toxoid and antibiotics. Immunoglobulins and monoclonal antibodies, there's a definite reaction of anaphylaxis, and that is minimized by the manufacturers by using only citric acid and sodium chloride, which are only tolerable to the human organism. Now, the monoclonal antibody neutralizes all the rabies strains in India. That's one of the things. Now, when we come to treatment of, say, immunization of the polio, vaccines, now we have got a three combined, so all the three polio vaccines have to be neutralized. Now, the monoclonal antibody developed by the Serum Institute, which is a parent institute in India, they have developed it, neutralizes all the strains in India from throughout the breadth of the country. It's the same thing, the local wound infiltration at all the needed anatomical sites. Higher dose of monoclonal antibody should not be used. Like higher dose of immunoglobulin should not be used because it interferes with the immune response to the rabies vaccine. Therefore, what we have used is only the directed specific use, and if you are not behaving, suppose there's some disuse of the thing, usually nurses and other staff, it takes another vial and start infiltrating. That should not be done. If you have started infiltrating thing, if you are not able to complete it, leave it at that, because it interferes with the immune response of the rabies vaccine itself. Therefore, rabies treatment, summarizing, has got four components today. One is wound toilet, second is rabies vaccine, third is immunoglobulins, fourth is monoclonal antibodies. Of course, I have not gone into the manufacturers, into the cost of the people, because I only went to him the amount he uses for sponsoring the lecture. Now I will ask him to answer what is the cost of it, so that it will reach the common man. The treatment of rabies in the common man, worldwide, is the cost. Even best is the cost of treatment. But fortunately, we have a good government setup. Very early morning, if you see, walk into the camp, see people properly following where my house is near to it. So many people are vaccinated free of charge. Therefore, these are the four groups of treatment we have got: wound toilet, rabies vaccine, immunoglobulins, and monoclonal antibodies. I await any questions.
Frequently, a patient comes and asks us, it's a common scenario when they visit a doctor. The doctor has got a pet dog. The dog invariably bites the patient. The doctor reassures him that the dog has been immunized. Is it mandatory on the part of the individual to be vaccinated, or we can wait and watch?
The question is a very valid question. Correct question, as well. Now, as I have gone through two, three people, the authorities have worked in the area. Now, their answer is very clear. Once a disease comes, there is no salvation. So far, only 6 people have survived after the proof of rabies vaccine throughout the world. This one is from India. Now, you have to immunize the patient. If the scientific evidence is, if the dog is immunized, you will not get the disease. But don't take the risk, immunize. Now here, some people recommend pre-exposure prophylaxis. That is good enough. 0714. I think our approach to be, if you are sure of the history, the pet dog, sure of the history, the pet dog has been regularly immunized, go for a pre-exposure prophylaxis.
Sir, another basic question is, this vaccination, it induces active immunity, correct?
Yes.
It stimulates the immune system to produce antibody. So the antibody is generated before the virus actually enters the nervous system.
Nervous system.
So it's only with antibody which neutralizes the virus.
Yes.
So the vaccine doesn't travel along the nervous system.
The vaccine also, because it is a virus, some of them may get activated in the body. May get activated in the body. That's what some people say that. But now any suggestions on this point?
The mechanism is the antibody.
Am I immune producing?
Actually, sir, this question is very valid. But here you are giving antigen.
Correct.
That is, antigen will go. That travels. It is a neutrophilic substance. That is vaccine. What you are giving.
Correct.
That is. So not a immunoglobulin. Immunoglobulin means it will block the whole antibodies.
That is passive.
No, that is passive. This is active. This is an antigen. It's prepared from that and immunize. So this will travel along the nerve. So if you give through the nerve, it will go through the nerve.
No, but how will the antigen neutralize the virus? Our concept of
antigen which triggers the immune response. So instead of just traveling into the blood and going, it is a neutrophilic drug, antigen. It travels. They are traveling, it produces more and more antibodies.
So the antibody finally neutralizes.
Exactly.
The virus.
So this active immunization. Passive immunization is what the sound was telling you. That is immunoglobulin.
Yeah,
so that is it.
So the time taken to develop rabies is more than the time taken to generate the antibody.
No, the time taken to generate the antibody should be first. Otherwise, we'll get the disease.
That's what I'm saying. Time taken is shorter.
Now, the usefulness of the two things, immunoglobulins and monoclonal antibodies, is to reduce the viral load and delay the development of the travel of the virus. So, our vaccine, all are complementary. All three are complementary.
And if you're bitten by a rabid dog, I think you should give both, active and passive.
Yes, both. Both. I have not gone into the details of the wound classification 1 and 2, 3. Yes, I got a thing. Thank you.
How often do you have to repeat the booster dose? That is for
compliance. 6 months. 6 months you should do.
Yeah, booster dose. That depends, sir. Actually, if you suspect, see, most of the time, what the clinical practice, if you come to the government hospital, some 100 people are standing there. All are bitten by dog. It's a clear cut evidence of dog bite. Are they, how many cases of rabies you have seen by in your practice? Definitely not, if at all few in your lifetime, that's all. So the rabies incidence is, that itself is low. So if you have a high index of suspicion, if it's a rabies dog, evidenced by the other things that you know, behavior, all these things, probably you can vaccinate again. So you have to vaccinate, then once in 6 months or once in a year. That's so there is no different guideline how frequently you have to give a booster, but most of the times the vaccines are, it has to be given.
1, 3, 6 months, sir. 1, 3, 6 months of re-vaccinated. 1, 3, even if it's vaccinated, 6 months.
First,
sir. Any other questions, sir?
Suppose we go on third day, patient comes on fourth day, no problem. As early you improve.
So,
thing is that idea is to improve the immunity. So, you give more antigen, so more antibody generated, the antibody blocks the this thing, virus. That's an idea. So, if it missed, probably you give next, as early as possible.
Within 6 months, you give a very new
vaccination. Unless he is bitten again, no revaccination. Should be done. Say 6 months after I give it, sir. Please. Any other comments? Sir, disease vandurthana, you will have a social problem. Better vaccine. Especially with the present vaccines, immunity is slightly less. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Next we move on to the policy. No, I guess Dr. Mani to handle that. Let us get a question. Thank you.